What is the name of your crew?
House of Swag Kids.
Where are you guys from?
Ireland.
Ooh.
Ireland, yes. So who's the youngest? And how old are you?
Six.
And what's your name?
Madison.
Madison. So what makes you different from the other dance crews we've had on Britain's Got Talent?
So we have a message, basically positive mental health.
Wow. A very, very powerful message. Is there a particular reason that you've taken on this issue?
Some of us have gone through a lot with mental health, so it's just an easy way to let it all out when you can't find the words.
OK. Good for you. Brilliant.
We're a dance school with a big message. We promote positive mental health through performing arts. This is such a big topic. Everybody in the group has been touched by it. You could be so down in the dumps, and then other days you could be so happy. It's so hard to talk about it, but dancing about it makes everything so much easier.
You always feel like free, and if you have anything on your mind, like you can talk, like the way we do our circles, where we just talk about our problems.
And like how we write what are the troubles on our hands when we dance.
Show everybody that it's okay not to be okay, isn't it?
Being on Britain's Got Talent is a really huge thing for us. Honestly, just amazing.
Well, look. We are all excited to see what you guys are going to do. So, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
It's not that I don't want to be happy. No matter how hard I try, I can't bring myself to be happy. I just want to scream for help. I feel so alone and so ashamed. Everyone says I'm too young to be feeling this way. I feel scared and alone. Why do I have to be this way?
There was a time I was alone. Nowhere to go and no place to call home. My only friend was the man in the moon. Even sometimes it would go away too. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me. Away from all of reality. Never let us hold to lost boys like me. And lost boys like me are free.
Billy.
What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know?
Come here.
I wanna end me.
Nobody likes you. Everyone hates you.
You are horrible.
You can't do anything.
I wanna end me. What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know?
Count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through. You got the love.
We need to talk to each other.
There's people out there who will listen.
Together we can make a change.
This is a issue that people find very difficult to talk about. And how wonderful to bring it to the stage here today. And so brilliant to see it in the medium of dance.
Yeah.
This is amazing. You know, you're shedding light on something very difficult. And of course, let's not forget, you're brilliantly talented dancers.
There was a lot of flavour in there, and I love the way you put the whole thing together with yourself, young man, being at the front, telling the story.
Fantastic audition. Well done.
Children listen to children. It's a very strong message here, and I can see a lot of potential.
You told the story really, really cleverly.
Yeah.
What we're seeing this year is younger people coming on and actually educating us, which is amazing. Because you've got the passion, right?
David?
Let me start this off with a yes. Alicia?
Yes.
It's a yes for me.
Okay, House of Swag. You now got four yeses.
What's your act?
Underwater escape act. I will be locked up inside, chained, handcuffs, and padlocks.
Wow.
I will be attempting to unpick these padlocks, but first it will be up to you to select the correct key that opens the padlock on the outside of the box. So you'll be responsible if I survive or not.
Oh.
Wow. How dangerous is this?
Houdini's record was 3 minutes and 30 seconds. And at that time, it is a possibility of dying, yeah.
Okay, I am not encouraging you to do it, but I'm really excited. Good luck.
Thank you.
I got a padlock and 5 keys. Only one of these will open the lock. I'm gonna need 1 key each. David, would you just try it in the padlock? It does not open?
No.
No, please leave the key in there and pass the padlock to Alicia.
No.
Amanda.
Nope.
No. Son.
No.
No. One last key.
It does work.
It does work, good. Leave it open and leave
the key in the glass.
So only one of those 5 keys will open the padlock. David, bring the padlock with you up on stage.
And here's some lock picks. We'll get back to them later on.
We are going to lock Christian inside. He's locked in with chains around his belly, handcuffs around his wrists, chains around his neck, everything locked down to the bottom of the tank. His life is in your hands. There we go. Start the timer. Get the padlock over here, David. Solid on. Good. Good. Perfect. Yeah, you can go back down. You can go back down. Christian is locked in.
And now it's down to you guys to find the correct key. Only then will we give Christian the lockpicks to free himself.
Take the glass. Take one key out.
Oh, don't like this, Tom.
I don't like this.
He's breaking the keys.
Simon.
Does the guy in the box know he's doing this?
This is crazy.
Alicia. Two keys left, David. That one?
Yeah.
There, one key left. David, come on, bring it on stage.
Quick.
Fast as you can. We are almost 2 minutes.
Yes!
Yes, it's open! Hey! Oh, the lockpicks, grab lockpicks, please.
Two and a half minutes.
Four locks to pick.
I don't think I'd like to rely on Hans.
No, he's a bit forgetful, isn't he?
Three minutes.
She's been there for 3 minutes in the oxygen.
Oh my God.
3.5 minutes.
Oh God.
If we go over 4 minutes, we're in a very bad place.
Right, this is danger time now.
One lock left.
You're shaking it then.
Oh God, I feel
this is hard to watch.
4 minutes.
Look at his legs.
No, he can't get it off. He can't get it off his shirt.
Guys.
Get him out. No, get him out.
Come on.
How are you feeling?
Unchained.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening.
Why are you not doing?
Good evening.
Only you.
Is it you not doing
it? I did it.
You did it.
Huh? I said it.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you.
Sorry.
I need a volunteer. You. Come up on stage. What's your name?
Amanda.
Amanda?
Yes.
Tell the truth. Is that you?
Yes.
Here I have two boxes. I want you to choose one of the boxes. Now, turn around, back to back. I want you to open the box. Inside, you will find plastic bags with different colors. Mm-hmm. I want you to think at one of the colors and take it out. Now, put the box on the floor. Open the plastic bag with two ends and think on the color. Now, I want you to count to 10 slowly, and both of us will turn to the audience at the same time. Mm-hmm. Start counting.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Well, wait, start from the beginning.
One, two, three.
Slowly.
One, two.
Yeah, now it's good.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Thank you. It's souvenir.
Thank you.
But wait.
Oh.
No, I took something from you. You didn't even notice. Chegwood, what did I take from you?
What?
I took something from you. You're missing something. Here is your watch!
Thank you. Oh, it's good.
And you? I took something from you too. Good, what did I take from you? Here is your watch! And you?
Thank you.
No, your wallet! What's inside? Your watch! Thank you! Thank you!
Oh, he's brilliant! The head hurts from laughing.
Are you ready, Dad?
I'm ready, son.
Let's do it.
That's life. That's life. That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shut down in May. And I know I'm gonna change that too. When I'm back on top in June. I said that's life.
That's life.
It may seem some people get their kicks just stomping on a dream, but I won't ever let it get me down, 'cause this ride on world, it keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a bopper, a pirate, a poet, born in a king. I've been up and down, over and out, and I know one thing, it's time I find myself, laying flat on my face. I pick myself up and get back in the race. This is life.
That's life.
And I know I can't deny it. Sometimes I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart ain't gonna buy it. And if there's nothing shaking this July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and die by my.
Thank you.
Terrible breakup a couple of years ago. We were together for a good chunk of time, 5.5 years. We were in a serious relationship, serious because we never had fun together. It was a bit of a low point, actually. I remember it was Monday night. I'd been back at home with Mum and Dad for about 2 weeks, and I found myself typing into Google, is it normal for you to miss someone that you've broken up with? I did learn one thing from that Google search, and that's that I must be very feminine. Every single answer was aimed at women. Of course, you'll miss him. I'm going, it's her. Remember the reason you broke up with him? I'm going, it's her. So I just went to the shop and got a big bag of Maltesers, a bottle of rosé and had a bath bomb. It's a cracking night. I love a bath bomb, me. It was actually my ex-girlfriend that got me into them. She bought me a couple for our last Christmas together. I mean, it was a rubbish main present, I'll be honest with you, but... As I said, we're not together anymore, but she lives on. She lives on every time I go into Lush to buy myself a bath bomb. I can't admit I'm buying bath bombs for myself. It's not a very manly, masculine item to buy, is it? So I wander in there like I don't know where I am. My girlfriend sent me. She's after some bath grenades. I don't know what they are. She doesn't like the glittery ones, I know that much. Get stuck in her chest there. Oh, no, she just don't like them. I love a bath generally. I don't always have a bath bomb. They're £4.50 a throw, aren't they? They're for birthdays and Boxing Days, special occasions. But... And I've got a little tip for you, gents in the room. I can't speak for the ladies. If you are having a bath with a bath bomb, a lot of people fill the bath, throw the bath bomb in, and then get into the bath. I don't do that. I fill the bath, I get in the bath, and then bath bomb under the... Get a little bit more for your £4.50. So that's me. That's me. Thank you.
Trying to hold my breath, let it stay this way. Can't let this moment end. Set off a dream in me, getting louder now. Can you hear it echoing? Take my hand, will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you, shine of a thousand spotlights. Oh, the stars you steal from the night sky will never be enough.
Poor girl.
Never be enough. Towers of gold are still too little. These hands could hold the world, but it'll never be enough. Never be
okay? Yeah?
Never for me, for me. Never enough. Never enough. Never enough for me, for me, for me.
You must be absolutely sick to death of card tricks. Like, you won't want to see one at all for the rest of your life.
How did you know that?
I've got friends. Instead, I'm simply taking a red handkerchief and pushing it into my fist. I'm then going to snap my fingers and show, look, it's turned into an egg and the handkerchief is back in my pocket.
Your brother's magic!
Now, today, I actually thought it would be fun to teach you this trick. Everything isn't quite as it seems. Because, look, there's a hole in the back of the egg and that's where I've hidden another handkerchief. It's that simple. David, are you with me still?
Yes.
Yes, good. Right, OK. So here's the setup. Take out your red handkerchief and you simply say you're going to push it into your fist. But what the audience don't know is that it's actually going into the hole. Right? So then you snap your fingers and you show, look, it's an egg and the handkerchief is back in your pocket. The one thing that you have to remember to do is not show this side of the egg. It'll completely ruin the trick and the magician, well, it'd look like a bit of a fool, really. Unless, of course, you're a real magician.
Oh.
And you can simply remove the hole.
You cracked the egg!
It's a real egg!
I'm Jasper Cherry. Thank you. Goodbye.
We would start this evening by creating a brand new business here live tonight with you guys. It could be badminton lessons. What sort of business do you want to see?
Sells Wellington boots.
Sells Wellington boots, David? Of course it sells Wellington boots. But we're going to get a very specific type or group of person to make our Wellington boots. It could be firemen or ballerinas. Who's going to be doing it? Judges?
Air hostesses.
Air hostesses. Of course it's going to be air hostesses. And this one is a question for the audience in the room. What I would love is a celebrity who is going to be in charge of our business. Any celebrity at all. Shout them out, audience. And I'm dead. Guys, we've got a new business for you. So, from you, could we please get a big old round of applause as we hit the music and take it away?
Guys, I've got an idea.
What's that, Tom?
Your brains, it's going to hurt.
Okay.
It's a brand new business. We'll make boots for stomping through the dirt.
I like it.
But it's so much more than that, friends. People ask us why. It's air hostesses making them at least a mile high.
Tom, I like this idea. Yes, you know we're all in cahoots. Yeah. If David was making them, then they would be called Wellington boots. Yes, my friend, these will be perfect. Stitch and to stitch, we've got Ant and Deck there in charge. I'm still not sure which one is which.
Which one's the one with the forehead?
They've both got foreheads.
That is true.
That's true.
They do both have foreheads.
What are we going to call the business, man?
Simple name for it. Ant and Deck Swellies.
Yeah!
They might beat them in the jungle, Ant and Deck Swellies. Yeah, but they are always ready to rumble.
Good choice.
Oh, guys.
On your feet.
So sorry. Oh, friends, you need to know.
High and high.
My feet.
With the boys.
So dry.
We'll start it in Biker Grove. Ant and Deck Swellies. Yeah, they might beat them in the jungle, Ant and Deck Swellies.
This is a good idea. This is a good idea.
Yeah, but they are always ready to rumble. You need Ant and Deck Swellies, and they're ready to rumble.
Thank you.
not a straw.
What is it?
It's a straw.
It's a straw. It's a straw. It's a straw. It's just a straw.
Final straw.